Hi guys, so what I have to share with you today is my full-on custom Lego antique shop. This custom build does serve as part of an addition to Brick Melbourne and as well as part of the Fusion Derps the 90 custom build competition. By the way, I'm gonna go link his channel in the description and I'm gonna link his channel in the comment section below. You guys can go over and check him out. Now with the whole pattern design for this body, I had decided to include many various different colors as I had decided to bring in a lot of life to this body. Now with the exterior of the building, I had decided to include the 60-year sign to represent that everything inside this building has got to be a minimum age of 60 years. I have included these two windows to let in a lot of light and as well this archway. So this would be greeting guests, new guests to come in. So they could basically drive up here and they could exit and they will be greeted by this very, very nice archway, which I decided to include, as well as with the whole patterns. You guys are probably curious about why isn't this just one color. Well, with the whole pattern design and all, I had decided to include many various different colors for this custom build to bring it a lot of life. And as well, I had included a type of a pattern design for the facade of this body, and that is to greet and welcome the guests. Here you guys have a look at the remaining three sides of this building. I have included the orange, the red, yellow, and the blue pieces over here. And this basically just extends as a pattern throughout the whole building. I have included as well this window over here to again let in light, and as well this back exit door. And you don't want to get all your employees wet, so basically they can have a vehicle parked out here and this ramp will prevent them from getting all soaked up, and they can basically come in and exit and just drive away. So those are some of the play features which I had included in this build. So here we are back to the facade and back to the front, and now let's take a look on the inside. So what you have to do to gain access to the inside is just gently pull off this roof. Comes off in one piece like that, and these 16 by 16 face plates. So it's like that, and that's all, and that basically gives you full access to the inside. When you walk inside here, you are greeted by this golden fence piece over here with a drum kit, a pretty olden day style drum kit to your left, and as well as these old scuba diving equipment to your right. So if you just keep walking down, you will see this display of ancient, I would say medieval time items over here. We've got a guy inside there testing out all of these items, and I would say the worth price of these items would be around a few thousand dollars. I would say probably like 28,000 for each item, or maybe more, because they are pretty ancient, pretty expensive. So we got the guy testing them out, and these are actually all of these items. They are from 1432. So we've got some pretty old items over here. We've got this drum kit, which is original and very, very rare, and the actual first in Brick Melbourne. The price for this drum kit is about over 200,000, maybe actually over 300,000. So this is a very, very expensive items. We've got the guy looking at them over here, and over here we have this jail door. Now you guys are thinking, now what is this jail door for? Well, this is a jail door from 1784. This is from a ship from 1784. This is why this is in place in an antique shop, and this costs about 100,000 because it is it's still preserved from that time, and it is next to this pirate ship over here, or a olden style ship, and this is basically a model. And the pricing for this is and the price for this would be around 60,000. So this has got to be one of the cheapest items in this store. And now I want to get you a better angle and a better view of the aquatic equipment. And this, each of this equipment costs about 90,000. So pretty expensive stuff. Unfortunately, the food is not for sale. It is just for him. So when he gets hungry, he has to eat. And that is so he doesn't have to get replaced by someone else. So he basically can spend the whole day in here. He has all his food supplies. So he can, you know, do his work, sit down to basically sell out stuff to basically, you know, basically to provide service to shopping customers. And when he is pretty hungry, he can just sit down and eat some food. Here you guys can have a good look of the store. There you guys have it. That is my fully owned custom antique shop. So you guys will be seeing this in the next Brick Melbourne, the next city update. Let me know what you think of this custom build. Tell me if you think that this build, tell me about any suggestions I could improve this build on, or in any way I could improve this. And that's all I have to talk to you for today. So thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you very much for hearing out my thoughts and what I'm sharing with you. And yeah, I'll be talking to you guys again very soon.